I'm going to make a metal barrel with water in it. So first I'll make a low poly cylinder and just mark the seams to unwrap it. And I'll search online for free textures. I'll put some links in the description for some good sites to use. I'll be using this metal and puddle textures here. Bring them into an image editor, scale them down. 128 by 128 is a good resolution for these. And then just put them on your model. Remember that the smaller something is, the smaller its texture resolution should be. And every element in your scene should have similar size pixels on their textures. For materials, the PS1 supported unshaded and garage shading, which most engines don't have as a default option these days, so you might have to get some shader code for that online or write your own, though most people probably wouldn't notice the difference if you used a generic Lambert shader instead. Make sure to disable texture filtering so you get that pixelated look. The PS1 did not support texture filtering. You'll also need a custom shader that emulates the affine mapping the PS1 did, which is what caused that distortion effect that it's famous for. I've linked in the description a couple places you can find shader code for that. Finally, change the render resolution to 320 by 240. This is the resolution most PS1 games were rendered at. For making characters, you pretty much do the same thing. Just for textures, I like to find pictures of front, side, whatever I'm making, plus close-ups of detailed parts like faces, and then you can just cut what you want out of pictures and compile them into one texture and then scale that down. Also, for character limbs, early PS1 game characters tended to have limbs that were separate segments, and this is the look that most people associate with PS1 characters, even though later games did have rigged meshes. So if you're trying to exploit that nostalgia, then do segmented limbs. And that's pretty much all there is to it. If you want a more detailed look, I've linked a stream in the description where I make the main character from Death Stranding in a PS1 style.